On this episode of NSFW Show, we appeal to the Supreme Court of Chatrealm on the most important issues of the day. Oranges versus Apple Computer Company. It will be decided tonight. Also, big announcement on Night Attack 2 when we talk more Ruin 'Em Wine. It's all coming up next on NSFW Show.
Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit. Bandwidth for NSFW is brought to you by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
This is NSFW episode 171, recorded on March 26, 2013. Don't touch me.
This episode of NSFW Show is brought to you by Pond5, the world's stock media marketplace. If you're a media maker looking for video, photos, illustrations, music, sound effects, After Effects templates, or 3D models, check out Pond5. And for an exclusive 50 free stock media files, go to pond5.com/NSFW.
Trying to slice Manus open. Consistently testing that midsection of Manus. Manus getting beaten on.
What's the back of the head?
Could be in trouble here, Manus. But Manus is relaxed here, Pat. Still riding the back of Manus. Good defense here from Manus. Manus flattened out. Manus flat on the canvas. We are ready to rock and roll. Second round of action. There is a cut on Manus. Manus is ready to pounce here. The rip shoots in early. Manus defends it. Manus is in a bit of pain here.
You watch one, I'll watch the other, Michael.
I'll watch Manus. Manus taking a thumb. Scathed, and the ringside physician has just popped in there to look at Manus. Manus trying to work the clinch. You hear the referee saying, stay busy, Danny. He's left the arm in as Anus. Manus could be in trouble. Manus just stuck here. And he pops the head out. Manus all bloodied up here.
Well, Manus is bleeding all over Chavez's chest.
Manus just bleeding all over Chavez. The corner crew go to work on the cut on Manus.
All right, that's it. We got to go. That means it is go time. NSFW, that's right, the new show full of wind, the new sauce for the webinars, the show that is nominally safe for work. Oh, hello there, Chatrealm, I didn't see you. I'm Brian Brushwood, your humble co-host, along with my BFF, Mr. Justin Robert Young, all the way from beautiful Las Vegas. What is going on, Professor J.R.Y.?
Holy crap, Brian, we got a big fat show today, because we're drafting the Summer Movie League.
What? But Justin, I thought we weren't able to do that because Sarah Lane had a conflict.
Nope.
And Dan Dirks, the commissioner, is...
And the first movie on the board is...
We just chop it up together, and we make like we do proxy votes for all of ourselves, and then we just dominate. We're like, yeah!
I bid $2!
All the movies go for $3. We form a cabal. Yeah, man, we originally wanted to do the NSFW movie draft today, but that did not happen because we had conflicts. The current plan is we're going to do it a week from today in a very special edition. We're doing an early in-studio NSFW Sunday Night Live right after Twit. Justin's going to be right here. We may record some Night Attack 2 stuff for you guys as well, which I will have some more news about that later on.
Well, we have a near big Night Attack 2 announcement.
Yes, big fat Night Attack 2 announcement is coming up, and a decision.
An announcement about the release date of Night Attack 2,
if
which
only
has nothing to do with Hitler's birthday.
Wait, what is Hitler's birthday?
I'm just saying it has nothing to do.
That's what I want people to do that in general. They're like, I don't want to say that. You know what I'm not going to say? I'm not going to say that your cable's gone out because of the fact that you're born, that this is an Indian burial ground. I'm not going to say that. I'm sure it has nothing to do with that at all.
Yeah. People are pointing out that we're just using the tried and true methods that Apple uses when they send out invitations to journalists, where it's like, we would like to invite you to a special event that may or may not be about Hitler's birthday. So anyway, yeah. I don't know. When are we going to make that announcement? Should we tease it?
Yes, at the end of the episode. Okay, well, we're teasing it all the way up until this exact moment right here. Can we? All right, we're gonna do a release date on Night Attack 2. For those of you who don't know the saga of the Night Attack 2 recording, first of all, once upon a time, there was a fantastic...
The Dr. Dre's Detox, or
the
or
Chinese
Guns
Democracy.
N' Roses Chinese Democracy.
Yeah, sure. We planned to Night Attack 1 did really, really well, and we were really excited, and everyone really seemed to like it. Hit number 4 on the comedy charts on Billboard. We're like, let's do it again. And you're like, in fact, instead of doing it over Skype, we should actually fly out and get together. So we put it on the calendar. Justin's going to fly out. We're going to record. And then we launched Game On.
And we did.
Well, we intended to. We launched Game On, and we're so stressed about doing that that we spent the entire time when you're here just working on it all day. And then at the end of the night, it was like, we got to record Night Attack, man. You're like, well, we haven't thought about what we're going to say. You're like, let's just drink a bunch, and then it'll be funny. And so what we have is this mad collection of extraordinarily sloppy tracks. I think maybe 3 of the 25 to 40 tracks that we recorded did not involve genitalia.
Yeah, it was a lot of talking about our own genitals and the manipulation of said subject matter, and then things that happened before, during, and after. But there are some funny stuff, and it will be part of the album. We've since done a couple more recording sessions that are we think are very, very funny, one of which got turned into an epic thing that we will unveil at some point.
You had talked about teasing it, and I said it was a bad idea, but now I kind of want to tease the Jackie Hearn's work. I feel like we wandered down this path, and I feel like we just got to kind of tease it and show as much as we can about it. You think it's a bad idea? If you say so, we can divert.
Should we play a little bit of it and put it up on maybe nsfwshow.com/album, where you can also get links to buy the first Night Attack album and sign up for a mailing list where you can be alerted and get special bonus content?
nsfwshow.com/Night Attack or album?
Album. nsfwshow.com/album is where you get all the Night Attack information. Again, buy for super cheap our first album, Night Attack. Night Attack 2 will be out April 20th, but it will include I think we should just play up to the punchline on this, and then everybody can go see the full uncensored video at nsfwshow.com/album.
All right.
But it will include, Night Attack 2 will include this track, which was put to an epic visual representation with puppets for me and Brian.
It's
by Jackie Hearn.
Jackie Hearn,
brilliant genius.
It's amazing. It's us as sock puppets doing a PSA. Enjoy,
Brian. I think it's about time we did some good.
Yeah,
we got to do a PSA.
Prostate exam?
No, that's a public service announcement, Brian.
Yeah, I would.
Here's what we got to do. We got. There's a problem. We all know.
Yeah.
Let's say you go to a bar.
Yep.
Have a few brewskis.
Sure.
With your pals.
You're fine.
Well, I mean, what are you going to do? Leave your car?
Well, you got to do the math. What you do is you take your weight, and then you subdivide by the cosine.
Drink while you're doing the math.
And then you do the math. You're like, yeah, no, I'm good. I'm good.
Drive home.
Yeah, pretty much. Sure.
Drunk driving.
Okay, I'm sorry. Happens. Did you just say drunk driving?
Happens.
That's not. Nah,
Brian, I'm going to talk frank with you.
It happens. We don't condone... drunk driving, that's a bad idea.
Well, I mean, that's fine. We don't condone it.
Okay.
All right.
All right. But there is a thing. Okay, don't do it. Okay, when you say the wink thing, that's all right.
Wink.
All right, what is your point?
Separate conversation.
Okay.
We've all been in the car.
Mm-hmm.
All of a sudden, something real important comes in on your phone.
Sure.
Gotta text them back.
I have.
You
got to
read
one.
And text.
Well, you shouldn't.
You shouldn't.
No, that's
shouldn't.
Right, you should not.
My favorite part about extending a word is you can tell how little I believe in it.
The longer
shouldn't.
You say it. All right, gotcha. All right,
but it happens.
Yeah, all right.
Texting while driving happens.
All right, some people do that.
You want to know what should never happen?
What?
Hi, I'm Justin Robert Young.
Hey, I'm Brian Brushwood.
And we're here to tell you that no matter what, never
ever
get drunk.
And drive a car.
No. Oh. And
text?
while driving.
Is that where we're drawing the line?
That's
not cool.
Whoa.
All right.
You
all
right. Really? No, you don't think so? I just muted it through this part right here.
Then get drunk.
What's the
and start texting while you're driving.
So the ad has to start off with a guy drinking from a party and get behind the wheel. You're like, oh, he's totally gonna get in a crash. But then he arrives at his destination and has a great time.
Oh
and
my
then,
god! Yeah.
But then and
he's
then,
picking up chicks.
Yeah.
Everyone thinks he's cooler because he's been drinking.
Exactly.
He like crushes a beer can on his head as soon as he walks out.
And then another dude gets in the car and be like, you know, are you at the party, bro? And he's like, beep beep beep.
Oh
you know,
no. Kind
of swerving.
Business deals.
Yeah.
I just sold my company to Facebook while I was on the way here.
Exactly. Right. And then but arrives at his destination.
Uh-huh.
And then that's when it pans over, you and me, and we're like, Justin, texting, drinking, looks to me like a recipe for disaster.
Boy, awesome.
No, for disaster, because when you combine those two, and then like the texting guy kind of drinks, and the drunk guy gets a text.
Starts texting.
Yeah, and then they get behind the wheel, and they crash into each other.
Into each other.
Exactly.
I love it. The poetry.
And they die, right? And then they're like,
And it's like we're kicking it like 70.
All right, here, you're calling it right there? All right.
See the whole video at nsfwshow.com/album. All right. Night Attack 2 has a firm release date of April 20th, 4/20. The day, well, I'll tell you what, there were a lot of people that went to go play Bioshock today, and they were very, very excited because it was a great way to fill their day. I'm not going to say why, but on 4/20, this might be a great thing to listen to over and over and over and over again. It is a fantastic party favor for the stoner Thanksgiving that happens on 4/20.
It would be like stoner Christmas. It's like for the pocket. And what do you think the crossover? Real quick. All right. The Venn diagram of people.
Of weed smokers to listeners to this show?
Yes, exactly. Like how much overlap? Because I know we have some there.
Have you ever seen an eclipse, Brian?
I don't think it's that much. I'm not gonna
I think see. We're looking at, remember in Heroes when there was the eclipse and then everybody got superpowers? That's what I think we're looking at.
what do you think? People are suggesting maybe it's 4.220%.
We're seeing a lot of one-to-ones.
Oh, you know what? Maybe they should throw up a straw poll here. And you know, look at this. Super Geek has already censored the remainder of the video so that we're able to...
I'll tell you, I would say leave it because the rest of it is very visual and
yes.
You know, give everybody
and
a
the
real
visuals
good
are amazing
to
because
nsfwshow.com/album. Get on the mailing list. We're going to give you special deleted cuts for free on the mailing list. And also we'll let you know when everything is live. And also if you're listening to this for the first time and you want to hear a comedy album where I tell a funny story about my uncle getting high and taking me out of school and to laser tag and all sorts of other really funny stuff. Go ahead and check it out, including the TIB, the mystery of the TIB. Go ahead and buy our first album.
TIB. Yeah, dude. It was not bad. Not bad for what? $2? $3? Something stupid. Oh, that's
yeah,
the other
cheap
thing.
Cheap as hell.
We are gonna have to raise the price on Night Attack 2 all the way up to $3.99 because Billboard like we hit that number 4 on Billboard partly because we had such a cheap album that and people were like buying it as gifts for friends and to crack down on that like because I guess Madonna her MD&A album she released originally at 99 cents to guarantee that it hit number 1 and then raised it to full price.
Yeah.
And so she got 2 honors. First of all, she hit number 1 like she wanted, but that wasn't what the newspapers said. What the newspapers reported was the next day when they said Madonna has the fastest dropping album in all of music history, like going from number 1 to all the way on down. So we'd like to be that in the world of comedy. But so Billboard changed the rules saying that you had to...
broke the rules, Brian. Now we'll pull out all their pubic hair.
Took me a second to realize where you were headed with that. Now I just want to sing the rest of the album. So they changed the rules to where now albums have to be $3.99 in order to count for the Billboard thing. And it was so much fun, man. One of the greatest, like, there's like 20 moments that just hit you like greatest moments ever. You know, for me, the first time I did the Tonight Show, and if you watch, there's this moment when I feel the liquid for the human crazy straw going across my forehead, and I realized that it worked, that there wasn't a kink in the straw, and that it was gonna work, and that was the first moment I relaxed. You could see me fighting a smile as it works, because it's like I take a mental snapshot of like, this moment I need to remember forever. I'm on the effing Tonight Show, and this is happening. Right up there with that was me being out on the bike ride when they called and they're like, hey, it's Larry from Billboard magazine. And I was like, I don't want no effing magazine. I ain't gonna subscribe. Prince dead. And they're like, well, I just wanted to make sure I got your name right. Is it spelled Brushwood, B-R-U-S-H-W-O-D? I'm like, yeah. And they're like, and Justin Robert Young is spelled J-U-S-T. And I'm like, why are you telling me these things? And then he's like, well, how are we going to list it on the charts? And then at that moment of realization that you and I had a Billboard top 10 comedy album, greatest moment in the world. It was amazing.
And so there we go. All more on that as it comes out. But Night Attack 2, a long gestating project, will be released April 20th. Again, nsfwshow.com/out. But Brian, that's not why we're here today.
Go on.
We're here because we are going to be arguing for and against some very important topics.
What? Well, who is the arbiter of what's an important topic, Justin? What does it mean to be? I mean, look, I know that the gay marriage. Hey, what is the deal with the Supreme Court and gay marriage? I know that they're deciding on a thing, and I read the Onion article.
I think they're just saying, like, it's just they're somebody brought up gay marriage, and they're all like, "Ooh, you're gay married? No, you're gay married."
Turns out that the Supreme Court, all they're doing is sneaking out at night to secretly gay marry bros who've passed out next to each other. They go, like, not only is gay marriage legal.
Someone's like, Justice Kagan, because you're a Supreme Court person doesn't mean that you can marry people. And he's like, no, I can't, but I can gay marry people. You're gay married. Bong!
And then they wake up. It's like the missing kidney thing. It's just like they wake up and in lipstick it says, hire a divorce lawyer. You're gay married. Justice Kagan.
Yeah, so they're debating this gay marriage thing, which is obviously a very, very important issue in America. But it's not the only issue in America, and the Supreme Court can only take so many cases. Obviously, our legal system is very complex, and what you may not know is that serious issues resulting to the internet's importance come through this circuit court, the Supreme Court of Chatrealm.
Yes, exactly. The ideas come from the chat realm, and they're decided upon by chat realm. You and I, as licensed speakophiles, are by the state allowed to do our best to represent the interests of the cases on the docket. And Justin, what is the first docket on the case? Case on the docket.
Well, two. Listen, there's Justin. A lot of them that we can't. We can't hear all the cases that come in. Many that we are not going over. Banjo versus fiddle.
Ah, no, that's I know that's a contentious one. Our boys down in Kentucky have been fighting that, and unfortunately it just hasn't escalated to our level here on the NSFW show. Right now in the chat room, you guys go ahead and put it. Bros versus hoes, of course. Long-standing debate.
AIDS versus cancer. Hotly debated.
I mean It's like this. You want to know what that was? That was the sound of my brain short-circuiting over all the possibilities where that
was
could
that
go
check
wrong.
Swing?
That was check swing. I think I got a full-on strike because I was just like, "What?" Then backed up.
We're looking at tacos versus Hitler.
Okay, you want? Wait. I'll take tacos, and you can take Hitler. You want to go and rock this one? What I love is the chat room just at some point breaks down and people just say just random stuff. Someone just says boyob and a bottle it. And all right, let's get started.
How about this one? Bronies versus furries.
I'm on team brony.
All right, you are arguing for bronies.
Yep.
I will serve as the representative for furries. Furries.
And I'll tell you what, I think my case is strong enough, I'll even go first, man.
As is tradition in the Chatrealm Supreme Court, the opposing sides get to nominate a voice for the opposition.
forgot about this little tidbit. This is a bad tradition. Go for it.
Can't argue with history, bro.
It's comedy gold, bro. This is how we go. All right, go ahead.
Ryan, it's not comedy gold. It's justice.
It's justice gold. In fact, it's solid gold with the Supreme Court justices on it.
Brian, I'm going to ask you or request humbly that you do the voice of a lustful robot.
Ladies and gentlemen, for 5,000 years, I have lusted after you. But today, that is not what I am here to talk about. Today, I am here to talk about the bronies.
I just want to point out, unknown 32 in the chat room, already hard.
It is true that many people do not understand the brony culture. They do not believe that grown men should be enjoying a television show designed for children. However, having performed at the Canterlot Gardens, I can say they're pretty rad. These are people who don't give a rat's ass about what you think, and that's kind of what makes them cool. All right, I'm gonna stop the voice for a second, dude. This is
Ryan.
All right. Man, wrong, bad. I should have picked a better voice. Should have just gone like Data or something.
Punk rock was based on an entire subculture of children, of young adults who truly did not care what you think. You are seeing that in the brony culture. They don't care what you think, and that is rad. All right, go. Also, I want you to take off your shirts. Your witness.
As is tradition, Brian.
Oh, shoot. You, my friend, will give a defense for the furries. As somebody who sneaks in additional syllables to words that don't need them.
Okay. Brian. And chat realm of them.
Chat realm of them?
I humbly and sincerely ask you to please consider the case furry. Okay. Let me explain something to you. If you think that bronies are cuckoo, let me introduce you to the sub-bub-bub-bub culture that is based totally around going to conventions and banging each other.
Can we make this like the way people talk to each other in real life?
They make costumes in brilliant pageantry. They dominate the downtowns. They go into each other's rooms and express animalistic love all god the damn night. Furries are our nation's greatest pastime. Case closed.
Okay. All right, real quick, throw up a straw poll, chat realm. We're going to see what you got. I love pageantry. Somebody put together a straw poll. We'll see the results come in real time. Man, I'm really curious which way. Oh, my God.
So it's going to be strawpoll.me/12019.
There you go. Strawpoll.me. 12019. We got bronies versus furries. I'm going to skip to the results. Oh my gosh. Ooh, this one's going to be a tight one. Furries at 53 bucks. Oh my gosh. My bronies aren't representing. Sorry to hear this.
I kind of feel like this though, because Brian, you took the wrong tack in defending them, because if you're going to say commitment Furries got way more on the bronies in terms of commitment.
Yeah, but furries don't go out in public and like flaunt it and kind of revel.
Are you kidding?
Well, I don't know. Do they? I mean,
they have gigantic conventions. They I'm not even kidding. Like, they take over downtown Pittsburgh.
Well, no, I mean, at their conventions they do, but are they out and proud the rest of the time?
I mean, well, all right. I guess you have a point that you know, but like
the bronies are very.
I'm sure that they wear as much furry identifying paraphernalia as bronies do.
Oh, I would doubt that. I would imagine, like. I know some. I mean, Patrick didn't answer these.
Right. These are final. Let's go back
The bronies versus furries. Case is decided. Chatrealm has decided in favor of furries. Congratulations, furries, on your win. Well done, sir.
Listen, again, so many great cases. Racism versus anti-Semitism.
Wait, aren't they two flavors of the same thing?
Rum versus bourbon.
Wait a minute. You want to talk about two flavors of the same thing? See, that's the solution right there, my friend. Why can't we just have full body brony costumes getting it on? Wow. That's kind of perverse.
I got furries in the living room getting it on, and they ain't leaving till 6 in the morning until somebody gets a whole work through their suit.
Okay. What else you got on there? Let's see it from the chat room.
Ginger versus Marianne.
Oh, dude, that's no question, right? Of course, that's also a television show that's 50 years old. I don't know.
Yeah, I was going to say, you want to know what the answer to that case is? Nobody cares.
Yes, exactly.
How about this one? Stalking versus conventional dating.
That's not bad. I like Chewbacca versus bacon. You got, ad bot versus ad dragon. See, Justin doesn't acknowledge the ad bot. It's got to be something he believes in.
Number one, I don't even know what ad bot is. Is that like a new character that you're doing on your video game live streams?
No. It's difficult to explain. It's just really weird.
Nachos versus vodka, people are suggesting.
Nachos versus vodka? BioShock Infinite versus getting any sleep? All right. We got to pick one. Is there anyone else? Let's do bacon versus Chewbacca then.
Bacon versus Chewbacca. Brian, you had first pick, so I will pick Chewbacca.
Chewbacca, all right. And you could go first with Chewbacca.
as is tradition, Brian.
You will be, my friend, a northerner who is patronizingly talking down to a southerner.
Okay. Hi. Listen, okay? I don't know whether or not you've heard a thing called Star Wars where you're from, okay? But in the city, we have Cineplexes. Go to see movies. Can you believe this guy? One of the popular movies we've seen is Star Wars. It had a little character called Chewbacca. Maybe you've heard about it on the internet. He's a big, tall guy, very relevant to world culture. Everybody loves Chewbacca. And how about this? He kind of sounds funny, like you guys talk. He makes it sound like... It's hilarious. One day when you get a television, I highly suggest you watch it. It's called Chewbacca Star Wars. He's the best ever. I gotta go. Bye.
Okay. Thank you, northern man who hates southern man and patronizingly talks down to them. All right, buddy. I'm going to defend bacon. What you got? And I'll tell you what. Somebody get ready with the straw poll on this one so we can launch it as soon as we're ready. All right. What do you got?
I want you to be... enraged southerner who's too drunk to have this conversation.
You don't even know what you're talking about, man. You don't even know. You don't know. No. No.
I'll slap you upside the head. You tell me, you know, you should talk about your dog, man. Your fetish dog, man. You're going to go get on your knees and grab his furry old, big old dog dong and rub it on your face. Freaking, I'm going to call you an F word. You know what the difference is between your crazy dog, man, and bacon? I seen bacon. I eaten bacon. I put bacon right in my mouth. I didn't think, you probably did put dog in your mouth. Put dog meat right in your mouth. Put dog meat in your mouth. Space dog meat in your mouth. That's your name. Space dog meat in your mouth. And Satan lips. That's your name. You got Satan lips, meat dog in your mouth, mother. Tell you what, bacon is the real deal. That's all I'm saying. Put bacon in my mouth. Get out of here. Don't touch me.
Of course, as we all remember, the epic closing statement, don't touch me.
Your witness. Okay, so we got to pick which one of these. Oh, man, we got like eight of them. Which one is somebody? Okay, here's what's funny. Somebody made 12026, somebody made 12027, and then somebody made a poll saying, which poll should we use, 12026 or 12027? We're going to use 12027. That's the official one. That's the official one right there.
And Brian, we will get to those results after our first ad read of the night, or our only ad read of the night.
Yeah, that's right. We should take a moment to thank the people who make this show possible. And let me tell you what, I got to chat with these guys last year at South by Southwest. They're awesome, awesome people. They are friends over at Pond 5.
Brian, I dropped something here. Let me pick it up.
Okay, is this going to give you one of those weird things where I'm going to have to do the ad again? Or, I mean, I didn't prepare. Do you have the ad ready? Are you even there? Justin.
Pond 5, Brian. That's where you need to go for the world's best stock media marketplace.
You're doing it again.
Brian, I know that everybody here in this audience is not only a media listener, but also a media maker. That's why Pond 5 is for you. You can download many stock clips as well as audio samples and 3D renderings.
Like no, nothing I say will affect you. This is you're off the show. You've been ejected from the show. You're fired. How about that? Does that do anything for you? You're fired.
Of course there's more, Brian. Vector illustration, sound effects, customizable motion graphics templates, and 3D models.
Okay. Well, I'll try playing along. What else does Pond 5 have, Justin?
Yes, Brian. People can sell their works on Pond 5 as well.
See, awkward. All right, look, just give us the promo code. Is there literally nothing that I can... Did the ad bot break?
Brian, you can set, as a media maker, the price you want on your items, therefore making Pond 5 the most unbeatable library for any of your media needs.
This is not even... Okay, look, if you're going to turn into a robot and just read the script, then at least read the script and be consistent with what I'm saying. I don't even understand this. Justin?
You card. Of course you can get 50 free... images and illustrations for Pond 5. Pond5.com/NSFW is where you need to go.
If only we could find out some kind of code people could use, like pond5.com/NSFW. That's right, pond5.com/NSFW is where you should go to get your 50 free stock media clips and support them. Let them know over Twitter how much that we love them over there.
And remember, do it fast.
do what?
Pond5.com/NSFW, the world's best stock media marketplace.
Man, it just gets weirder every single time. I don't even understand. It's... Sup?
Licking old man's nuts.
Oh, this is just the weirdest thing. All right, you ready to find out who won between Bacon and Chewbacca? What?
We're just doing the show.
Sure. No, that's...
This is what we do. We read the ads, and then, we say something different.
Yeah, no, that is what we do.
In this case, it was flicking old man's nuts. I'll tell you what, I don't advise doing that, by the way. That's a bad look.
It's a weird thing for you to just randomly shout. All right, we got the results of our poll in. What do you know what the over-under is? What do you think? Who do you think won?
I'll tell you what, I think Southern Man don't need me around anyhow, and will have successfully repped.
And you're Bacon. Right. There we go. 120 votes for Bacon, 64 for Chewbacca. Decision. Boom. I need a like, and then a douche douche. I need a hammer that says the word douche.
A douche hammer?
Yes, a douche hammer. That's what you do to knock a douche in. There you go. Let me just knock that douche. A douche, 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 douche.
Yeah.
All right. What do you got next? Yeah. I got time for one more.
RoboCop versus Judge Dredd, of course. A lot of controversy on that.
Oh, man. R.L. Stine versus Alex Jones. The Doctor versus O-Doctor. Not bad. Let's see. next poll is peanut butter versus Nutella. I'll tell you what, man. I would go to the...
People are saying Apple, the computer company, versus Orange, the fruit.
That's pretty good. That would be like comparing apples to oranges, which I think
is... I mean, really, maybe the greatest case.
I think it's time. Apple Computer Company versus oranges, the fruit. I think we're ready. I guess it's my turn to go first then, huh?
Who would you like to represent?
Apple Computer Company. I think this is no-brainer. Sure.
Okay. And I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen... A hush falls over the court as Brian's star litigator is now bellying up to the chambers. It is Buttimus Wind Esquire.
God damn you, Justin.
People are already saying boyo.
I wonder if there'll be any cross-examination.
I don't know.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, this being the biggest one, maybe we should both make opening statements and then have a cross-examination.
Ladies and gentlemen of the court, eons. The fine work of Steve Jobs has made possible such fine devices as the iPhone in your pocket, the iPod in your pocket, the iWatch soon to be in your pocket, and the Mac Mini.
Why would the iWatch be in the pocket?
it'll be a pocket watch, as many people know.
It wouldn't be a wristwatch? It seems like it's going to be a wristwatch. Why would it be a pocket watch? It doesn't make sense. Like, people haven't worn pocket watches forever.
It's a Steve Jobs' decision before he died.
Well, he's dead. I mean, we don't even know whether or not he worked on the iWatch. If it is, if I think.
Yes, he did in Windsor.
He did it in Windsor.
Yes.
Why? Now I feel like you've just retreated to a joke that we've already been to.
May have done that. A little bit of false positive action. Let's get back to my point.
Why would Steve Jobs be in Windsor, Maine? I didn't think there is a Windsor in Maine.
He was at an herbal massage alternative message.
No, hold on. Wait, what Windsor in Maine? There is no Windsor in Maine. Explain to me how you get to a Windsor in Maine. Why Steve Jobs was there? Was he there recently?
They called Windsor... Apple is awesome. Apple is very good, boyo.
Yeah, I was going to say, do you have any closing statements?
But just boyo, I'm out. That's all I got.
All right, Justin.
All right.
I would like
people are calling that argument the Windsor knot.
All right, I need you, Justin, to defend oranges over the Apple Computer Company, the single most valuable company on the planet right now. Explain to me why oranges, the fruits, are better, and do it doing your best impression of the ad dragon.
I'll tell you what, Brian. I know tradition dictates that the opposition gets to name the voice. We are seeing. All right. Well, I'll tell you what. If We saw a lot of Alex Jones chatter. But if you want me to do the ad dragon, I mean, listen.
I mean, actually, you know what? Dealer's choice. Because if you could explain to me, honestly, straight-faced, why some orange lump of tree droppings... I almost won the belt. Tree droppings is somehow better than the Apple Computer Company. Then, you know, more power to you. Go ahead. Choose your weapon,
I'm just going to say it's going to be Alex Jones. And I would also like to suggest that the cross-examination come from one Piers Morgan.
Oh, sure. Who will sound an awful lot like Buttimus Wynn. Okay. here we go. All right. I'm ready. All right, go. all right. So... you want to explain
Pierce. Pierce,
listen.
You want to go ahead and explain to me why oranges, Pierce, the fruit eaten by Thomas Jefferson said that the Tree of Liberty must be replenished from time to time with the blood of tyrants. If you are going to do that, it needs to be an orange tree, Pierce. 1776 will happen again if I don't get a goddamn orange right now. Production scurvy, Pierce. You ever try to ride a boat without getting scurvy? Do me a favor. Explain to me why your people decided to come over to America if they didn't have an orange to give them scurvy medicine. 1776.
Is that all? Are you done?
I'll tell you, if you don't let oranges run free throughout this country, I support marriage between one orange and two oranges. If you take away our oranges,
Alex,
I'll say, orange, Alex, you glad you got the hell back to your country.
Alex.
Don't even begin to tell me about the... I'll tell you what, if you want to talk about that, how about you talk about the four fish that just jumped in the lake?
Alex. There's no evidence.
Explain to me. How do you put four pits in a pat?
Alex, there's no evidence whatsoever.
If you flip, Jack, flip. How is it going to flop? Pierce, you can't answer these questions. And if you don't want to, then you need to really examine why every fourth person has an orange slice in their mouth and it makes them look like a monkey.
All right.
Burger pills. I'm out.
We're going to commercial with that. Bottle it. that's a bottle lips is the one of that. All right. Somebody give us a straw poll. That is 12035. Strawpoll.me/12035. Results are coming in. Wow. Heavy on orange the fruit. And what? not the Apple Computer Company. Surprisingly enough, even though orange is the fruit. You wouldn't think, well, holy cow, man.
Oranges will ripen again, Pierce.
I just got a tweet from Murder Pills saying that oranges saved this country from them Brits. 1776, Florida, baby. Black Panda says he went to Infowars.com and voted for oranges. Wait, I'm sorry. Hold on. Maybe this will change your mind. Shocking new evidence showing up in the last minute. The government page for Windsor, Maine.
Well, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I believe I was unfairly maligned. As evidence, this last minute evidence clearly is the website windsor.maine.gov. I'm afraid it's a fraudulent case.
This is
nobody can. The Apple Computer Company is clearly the more dominant.
When was Steve Jobs there?
This is enough of your shenanigans.
Can you
Pierce.
Please name the date that Steve Jobs was in Windsor, Maine?
Pierce, 1776 will happen again.
Don't, you can't blend impressions. Stay in your lane.
This is, I'm afraid I must ask for a revote in lieu
There's
of the
There's
only
one way to get out of this.
Boy, oh. Pierce Morgan.
Hold on, wait a minute.
What? He just left. Is Adbot going to come back? That's kind of fun. Surprise there's not a bigger turnaround. I expected a little more love. What is going on, yes. Dude? What just happened?
No. Midzula, the Mike Gorilla of the old school,
Holy
just
cow.
Showed up here.
Dude, that's fantastic. Great to see you, Midzula, man. I'm glad you're able to make it.
Brian, he comes to Vegas and lets me know he's going to be here.
I see what you did there. I see what you did there. In my defense, I was only, it was like this. It was like, for a, that was my fault. Sorry about that.
Well, I'll tell you what, we have just come to the end of our Supreme Court of Chat Realm cases. So, I'll tell you what, I mean, do we have a few minutes left here in the show?
We can BS for a little bit. We got some stuff. What's going on? Are you doing a go game in Vegas?
Yeah, so big go game tomorrow, and then I am on the road. Hey, by the way, if someone can actually throw a link in the chat room for me, it'd be greatly appreciated. But new podcast featuring me and Brett Rounceville. We've been doing a couple beta episodes. It's on my SoundCloud. So soundcloud.com, I believe it's /Justin Robert Young. But go ahead and listen to that. Give us some feedback on it. It's going to be kind of a travel podcast because guess what, Brian?
Yes?
I don't know if you know this. What is the most notable thing in the life of Brett Rounceville?
The Amtrak. No, the fact that he's married to Katie Moe.
Well, yes. You were right the first time.
Oh.
As much as I love Katie Moe, Amtrak is way more interesting to random people.
Right.
You know what he has not done at all since he got off the road with Amtrak after building a big career-defining brand as the guy who travels around and experiences the world?
He hasn't traveled around and experienced the world?
Or talked about it at all. He built a career and then walked away from it, as he did with Amtrekker. He walked away from a career with Disney to do Amtrekker.
So you're holding his feet to his fire, I assume.
Well, no, soundcloud.com/Justin Robert Young. Now that we incidentally both have jobs that sends us all over the country, and in Brett's case, the world, because he just got back from Paris, we're going to do a podcast talking about travel stuff and just me and Brett bantering about. It's going to be a real fun time, but we really want Chat Realm's opinion on what you guys want it to be. So soundcloud.com/Justin R. Young. Justin Robert Young,
all spelled out. Yeah. And then you'll just click on The Adventures of Young Rounceville, right?
I did want to talk real quick about...
Yes.
The Adventures of Young Rounceville.
Right. All right, now I'm waiting for you. Go ahead. We had a Skype lag.
Yes. All right, BioShock, go.
Oh, dude. Have you... you are not a gamer, right? But you did write for a video game podcast? Yeah. So what have you heard about? I'm just gonna say flat out, like BioShock Infinite. I've been playing it on the live stream a whole bunch. It is amazing from like the tableaus that they create, the world that they've created, the depth of everything, the fact that structurally they make it to where there's a game benefit to snooping around looking for coins and upgrades and all this stuff. But along the way, that same act of looking for all this other stuff forces you to discover all of these plot devices, the storytelling, basically, whether it's these little, because the movie takes place or video game takes place in an alternate 1912, yeah. Where it's like you got this floating city in the sky and you got all these immigrant laborers that are second class citizens.
Well,
go ahead.
And let me just say this, because you, I am not a video gamer. However, I do now live in an apartment with an Xbox, and I'm going to play this game. And this is the reason why. The people who made this game, I mean, oftentimes when we review games and stuff like that, we give big props to people who tell allegorical stories to the things that we have in life, and many times they are racial issues and stuff like that. BioShock Infinite is a story in a fantastical world and universe, but like it deals with racism in a language for which we understand and find uncomfortable. And I'm very interested in the story that they tell with it, and I think it looks amazing. I do want to respect the people who are like, it is a fantastic story of a game, so we will respect kind of spoilers.
Okay,
here,
so we can avoid the spoilers, but I mean, there's it's okay to know that there's, you know, that racism is a theme that is dealt with in this. I think is fair to say.
Yeah.
You want to know this, Justin? Here's how much I clearly love BioShock Infinite. Is less than 24 hours after the game's release, because as we record this, it's been less than 24 hours. I've played it so much that Dwillart put together this BioShock Infinite cover with me as the main character. It says NSFW show on there. How amazing is that, dude?
No, it is awesome, man. It is so incredibly dope. I'm looking forward to doing it. I'm looking forward to talking about it. I think it just was something that we should mention on the show because you've done so much of it, and everybody can follow your Justin TV.
Yeah, justin.tv/scamschoolbrian. And it's such a weird channel. I do such a terrible job with it because, like, one moment you'll get on and it'll be a Night Attack, me and Darren Kitchen flapping our gums, or you and me just recording Night Attack 2. Other times it'll be me and my 9-year-old playing Uncharted together. It's such a weird hodgepodge of everything.
Dude, I'll tell you what. I think it's awesome. Everybody should check it out. Another, we'll say this.
Wait, I got one more thing, though. The Dwill Art is making amazing Twit-related art. Take a look at this Mega Man-themed thing they did. Did you see this, Justin?
Oh, my God, no.
Have you not seen this? This is okay, no. So it's a Mega Man level with the Ad Dragon as the main boss, and then all of a sudden, Justin Robert Young shows up holding a beer, flings a Diamond Club glowing symbol at the Ad Dragon, and destroys him. How awesome is that, dude?
That's insane. That's amazing. Yeah. I love that.
I can't believe you didn't see that. That's awesome.
Well, I'll tell you what. We have one thing. And by the way, you can get that dwilart.deviantart.com/gallery. We're going to talk just a little bit about the wine, the Ruinum thing, the next step that we're taking in that.
We're going to do that after, right? After the episode.
The new policy is going to be this. Because we don't want to, if you want, you can get a complete NSFW show and then not get the weekly updates on the wine. If you just, after the show, we're going to end it, and then that's going to be it. We're going to do a little bit, and there's not a lot to pick up on this week. But
In
the future, whenever we talk about stuff, if it's big, we'll talk about it in the show. Otherwise, we're going to talk about it after the show. So people can have their experience and not, if they don't give an F word about the wine, then they don't have to listen to it.
Right. Although we do hope you guys will buy it and tell your friends about it.
Well, when it comes out.
All right, we'll talk about this later. We'll talk about this later. All right, what else? Do we have anything else before we can wrap things up?
No, I think we're wrapping it up.
Right on, man. Well, this was all for an episode that wasn't meant to be, considering this was supposed to be our movie draft episode, and you're on the road, and I was unprepared, and we're like, I don't know, the Supreme Court, something about arguing. Let's just do that. Boom.
Tell you what, next week, two in-studio shows in 1 week.
Yeah, dude. We got to, that's right. You're going to try to make it back. So Sunday night, special night, NSFW show. And then Tuesday night, special night, special of the movie draft. And maybe we'll have a double-sized NSFW release on Wednesday for everyone. So that way everyone gets it at the same time as usual, but they get a double episode.
Absolutely.
Right on, man. All right, well, do me a favor, beautiful people. I love you intensely. I will see you next Tuesday. Then you
spend a single moment without Brian Brushwood. Oh, I'd rather be dipped in honey and fed to a big ant pile than do without Justin Robert Young for even a little while. Oh, NSFW, I love you. NSFW, I love you. Man, that was insane at the end.
Dude, that gif that somebody threw together from Night Attack 2?
That's insane.
Yeah. Man, I'll tell you what, you and I have talked about this before, but of everything of this fantastic NSFW show experiment that is ongoing and who knows where it's going to lead us, like the level of talent and ability that just is magic from the chat realm. Like that, like
I'll tell you what.
That Jackie Hearn sock puppet thing was amazing.
Insane. Absolutely insane. All right. Hey, listen, I do got to wrap things up quick because I got to do stuff and I'm going to hang out with
you. All right. Let's talk Ruinum. Can you or can you not verify that Ruinum was drunk?
We are live on the internet, though. Just for the record.
Wow, so somebody without a shirt definitely just walked past.
Who is that? A wild party up in this bitch.
Yeah.
Who is that?
That's the John, my coworker here with the Go Game.
Got it. All right, right on.
Yes.
Hey, John.
John, this is Mitsula, fan of NSFW shows in the room while John is getting out of the shower. Again,
even better. Even better. I think we got a new story here. All right, look, real quick, ruin them stuff. Where are we as far as, like, you said that the recipe has been submitted, right? But they have to finally approve it? Like, who has to verify it?
What is in our hands is labels. We had a couple really good labels that came in. I think are we settled on the Ruinum thing?
The ambigram definitely should be in it. I feel like the ambigram, I don't know if the source files are available, but like if you go to the doc, and if you need help, just throw out on Twitter if you want to participate, hashtag Chatrealm, and just ask Chatrealm for a link to it. But the document is growing phenomenally well. Lots of good stories and everything. I'm looking for the ambigram design-wise is perfect. I feel like it could be smoothed out just a touch if somebody has kind of a calligraphy background or something. But of the designs I've seen, I think my favorite one was, and I'm blanking on his name because I'm a terrible, terrible friend. Let me see if I can dig it up. It was Malachi. Is it Magic Malachi? I forget what he describes it as. But what he did, and I really dug it, is he had a black label with the ambigram sideways, kind of vertical on it, and it had like this swirly sword thing going down through it. And I loved the design. It's like I think it would look somewhere, maybe on the top level, it would just say Ruinum or something in there. But it looked mysterious, and I really, really dug it. I'd like to see that polished up a bit. Magic Malachi, there you go. IllusionistMalachi.com/Ruinum is here. Take a look at these. Tell me what you think of this. So I'm not a fan of putting the BB logo on there, but like in this case, he's got the label on there horizontally. I dug it more when he did it vertically like this. I thought this was a much more iconic image. Which one do you like better? Like, I think this looks really good.
I mean, yeah. I think if we're just going, like, just the name, then I like it on the side. I think it looks good. It looks differentiated. So I would say that.
So, oh, wow, this is pretty good, too, with a skull on there. I don't know. I like this one with the kind of devil's fork going through it.
Wait, go down to the skull one again?
Well, the skull one might be a bit over the top. Well, I don't know. The skulls. Yeah, man, these are really good designs. Malachi really brought the pain. Man, now that I'm looking at it like that, it looks like Malachi did clean it up appropriately. That really looks good.
I would say.
I say the vertical one will do something on the black background like this. And up at the top,
so we need high res, super high res.
Yeah, and at the top, no logo like this. And instead of the ambigram again, let's just have the word Ruinum on there. And
also, there's a very high likelihood that we're not going to be able to print anything on that top part.
Yeah, that's a good point.
So let's just focus on the label.
But I think that looks really, really good. Like that's a wine that I would buy just because it looks freaking dope. And it's like, it looks kind of evil and mysterious. Man, I'm really in love with this design.
Although I am a fan of putting like where it says like the wine that ends the world or whatever.
Yeah.
Like having like ruin them in a more readable.
Yes.
Thing there.
I'm okay with that. Yeah. We'll do something simple. Real.
Just so people know what it actually is.
Right. And
we're not going to be able to read the actual logo.
So what if it just says, you know, Ruinum, where it's, instead of it says the wine real big, it just says Ruinum. And then underneath it just says dangerous period, seductive period or something like that. And then it's just like,
I mean, I like the wine that ends the wine that ends the world.
I think that's too obvious. I think that's so over the top. It sounds silly.
I mean,
I think we can hint at that, but I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, I mean, you guys can hash it out in the doc. You guys could do. Or what if it just says the end? Ruin them. The end.
I mean, I think dangerous and seductive sounds kind of
gay. Fake. Maybe a bit fake. Yeah. All right.
I'm saying that it sounds like it should marry another phrase. And should have the right to.
Okay, well, let's start talking about the subtitle. Let's get a super high-res version of this vertical logo on there. Congratulations to Magic Malachi. I think you totally nailed it on it. This is coming along very, very nicely. It's going to be a good-looking wine. And it tastes good, and it will knock you on your ass. Because as we were talking about in the pre-show beforehand, at 20% alcohol by volume, every sip, that's a 40-proof alcohol. That's half a shot. Every sip, it's half vodka. What is vodka's what, 80 proof? And this is 40 proof? So you're just going to be sitting there drinking your half vodka. It's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
Okay. So, yes, man. All right, dude. So I guess that's it for this episode of NSFW. Thanks for sticking around afterwards.